Rosemont Market and Bakery started out in a tiny space on Brighton Avenue years ago. The market and bakery has expanded to other locations, one in Yarmouth and another on Portland's Munjoy Hill.
And if you're looking for something quick and easy, you can buy it there or you can make it yourself. Here's Jim Keithley with this morning's Morning Menu.
This morning we made a surprise visit to the Rosemont Market and Bakery up on Munjoy Hill. Inside they've got everything you need. Their shelves are stocked and their produce aisle is locally sourced to whip up something good. All right, we're back in the kitchen. We've literally put Joe Fournier on the spot here. We marched in, looked at your shelf, grabbed some risotto. What are you going to make? What kind of risotto for us?
I'm going to do a pretty easy risotto. I'm going to do mushroom, some kale. I'm a sucker for frozen peas, so we're going to put some frozen peas and some butter and parmesan and keep it real simple.
All right, how do we do it? Now, what kind of mushrooms?
These are cremini mushrooms, just real kind of standard. They're affordable, they're good filler, they taste good. But then I'm going to take some maitake mushrooms, which impart a great flavor, real deep, savory flavor. And I'm just going to throw these all right in there. Take a little white wine, neutral wine. You don't want to cook with anything too cheap because you're just gonna concentrate that cheap flavor. So I'm gonna let a little bit of that alcohol burn off. I mean, for the most part, once this is all done, there won't be any alcohol left in here. So this is where the technique comes in. And it's really about the motion and just getting all that starch out of the risotto. And over here I have a little beef stock. And you can use it any kind of stock. You could even use water if you wanted to.
Looks like this could be a full meal, not just a side thing.
Absolutely. I mean, you know, saute up some sausage or something, put it right on top. You've got all four corners represented. That is a half a stick of butter there. And you can see it all coming nice and pretty light. Just grated Parmesan cheese, you know, you could grate your own if you have the time. All right, so. You can just see that coming all together right now.
Well, Joe, it looks beautiful, first
Thank
of all.
Thank you, Joe.
Let me take a dive into it here. A lot of flavor.
It should be a lot of flavor.
Ma'am, we're going to have the recipe for you on our website, WMTW.com.